Hi, and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one, I'm going to talk about how do you move from a mid-level analyst to a senior analyst. Okay, so the reason for addressing this again, it's one of those common questions that people do ask because, you know, they when you come in at a junior analyst, you sort of don't know anything, but then you've picked up a tool and you know how to analyze the data in a certain way, and it's a transition into a mid-level analyst. But how do you move from mid to senior? What makes it, what do you need to do differently? Now, what I say to people is that when you're moving from mid to senior, it's not necessarily a quantitative thing that you're doing more, it's more of a qualitative difference, okay? So hopefully when you're a mid-level analyst, you're very good at analyzing the data, you're very good at using a tool of your choice to query that data, you're very good at importing data or exporting from your system, source system. So you're very good at all that technical stuff and you're able to provide outputs to your team who then go off and present or even directly provide outputs to your stakeholders. Okay, so what's the difference now then between going from mid to senior? You know, what does someone need to do? So the first thing I say, like I said, it's not a quantitative difference, it's not that you have to do more, it's more a qualitative difference. And the first thing you have to do is that you have to take ownership of the problem, okay? So what I mean by this is, as a mid-level, you might be given a problem to solve, but you don't think it's really your problem, you're actually solving for someone else. As a senior, you take it on as your problem, okay? And so the idea is that you need to understand the broader context of what that problem arises from, why the business is asking that question, and, you know, what would happen if you answer that question? How would it help the business move forward? Okay, so you take total ownership of that question or that problem, and then you provide the solution. You provide it in the solution in the context of the business. So you don't just say, "Oh, here's the analysis," and that's it. You say, "Here's the analysis, and this is what it means for the business." So it means that you take total ownership, and that's what I mean by taking total ownership of the problem. Okay, the other thing is, as a mid-level analyst, sometimes you might come across a barrier and you go to your colleagues and you say, "Oh, I'm stuck here," or you go back to your stakeholder and say, "I'm stuck here," and then the stakeholder's like, "Oh, let's maybe think about another way of answering it." As a senior, and hopefully you'll be practicing this some as a mid actually after a while, but as a senior, you don't go with problems, you go with a solution, okay? So you might say, "Look, we can't answer this question using this data, but we could do this and it would give you a proxy answer, or if we had access to this data, we could answer that problem. And I think the best way to get access to this data is work with so-and-so to get it, or I know this team has it and I just need your permission to go and approach them to get it." So what you will need to be is that you need to be creative in solving the problem, okay? But also creative in coming up with solutions, because what as a senior you don't want to be doing is saying, "Look, I've come a barrier, I don't know what to do." People are relying on you as a senior analyst to answer the question, and if there are any problems, for you to solve those problems and come to them with solutions. So especially solutions that need the business's buy-in for you to proceed, then you go with them. If the business doesn't need buy-in for those solutions, then implement those solutions by all means, okay? So you need to be creative in solving the problem and providing solutions. The other thing is, as a mid, you may not, you know, you may present, you may not present, and you may just produce outputs in terms of graphs, reports, charts, and all that kind of stuff, dashboards. But as a senior, you'll be expected to present a lot of your work and also be very good at defending your work. And that's because, like I said, if you've taken total ownership of your project, you're not just presenting a graph or a chart or a report or a dashboard, you're actually presenting a solution to the business. And therefore, you need to present that. And so you take all your work, put it into a nice PowerPoint. Unfortunately, yes, everybody still uses PowerPoint. You'd put it in PowerPoint and you would present your work to your stakeholders, and then you'd be willing to defend it, or you'd have to be good at defending it. Okay, so if they ask you, "Well, why did you do that? Why did you make that assumption? Why did you use this data set? Why is that number not matching that number?" You need to be able to have answers and be able to defend that work. Okay, the other thing is, when you become a senior analyst, is to be more proactive in identifying business problems. Sometimes you shouldn't sit there waiting for briefs or requests to come in. You should be going out and answering business questions, okay? And I don't mean just proactively just answering them randomly, but, you know, if you're sitting in on a meeting and someone says, "Oh, this is not working," or "Why are people not buying this?" You know, you should go away and say, "Hang on, why aren't people buying that?" Maybe do a bit of preliminary analysis and then go back to your stakeholder or to someone senior in the business, a sponsor or something, and say, "Look, I've noticed that the business has this problem. I think I could answer that question by analyzing the data and help you go beyond the problem, solve the problem, move beyond this area into the next. So, you know, you would want to be proactive in doing that, in identifying business problems and solutions, and then providing solutions to them. So you'd be proactive in trying to identify business questions or problems, and then providing a solution to them. So that makes you more as a participant in the organization in solving business problems, rather than someone who just supports the business, okay? So that's it. And then finally, a senior analyst should have very good stakeholder management skills, okay? So over your mid-level analyst experience, you should be building relationships with people. And when you're a senior, you'd be much better at managing those relationships. And the reason for that is you want to show that that the work that you do can have an impact on the business, okay? What you don't want to do is just deliver outputs, okay? You want to be able to show, like I said, going back to ownership of the problem, presenting the complete solution, you want to show, look, the work that I do helps the business move forward. It just doesn't just provide a number, it gives you an answer to a business problem, a broad business problem, that then helps the business either make a decision or do something that then helps them move forward, okay? So that's roughly what I would say you need to move from a mid to a senior level position. And like I said, these aren't quantitative things. It's not like you need to be more skillful in something or you need to do more analysis. They're more qualitative differences. And that's what I find analysts struggle with, because these things you can't just do by sitting on your own and learning more things. These are things that you can only do by engaging with the business, by being part of the business and understanding how the business operates. And I'll always go back to this thing, you need to understand how the business makes money and how the business operates for you to be able to provide effective answers. And that's what a senior level analyst should really be doing. Okay, well, thank you for listening to my video. If you have any comments, please put them below. If you have any questions also, please put them in the comment section, then I'll answer as many as I can. Please do like my video, and of course, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.